Good morning. We want to welcome you today to our Sunday morning online service here on Sunday, March the 22nd. We were encouraged to see how many people had at least some contact with our first online service on Wednesday evening, March the 18th at 7 p.m. There were literally hundreds of people who did connect with that first online service. We, of course, don't know how many watched the whole service or portions of it, but many, many of you did, and we're thankful for that. We're thankful that we live in a day where, in a time like this, we, though are not physically able to meet together, we can still get together in our own homes with our families, and by the means of these tools that we have, we can still together gather around the Word of God and worship the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So we're thankful for that. If you weren't able to watch that service on Wednesday evening at 7, if you weren't able to just to sit down at 7 and join in for that service, I hope you'll go back and watch it. We tried in that service to take some time just to explain to you how we got to where we are right now, the plan for our church and ministries over the next, at that time, 15 days and moving forward. And we wanted to just share with you just our heart about how the Lord led us to make those decisions that we made so far. The time that we find ourselves in right now certainly seems surreal. Many of us are experiencing things that are firsts in our lifetimes. And it's certainly challenging as born-again believers not to be meeting together for a short time in a physical way. That's something that we know is such a great value to us, that fellowship of the church, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together. But of course, at this time, we do believe that that is the best thing that we can do. But we believe as well that it will be only for a time. We're trying to do all we can to stay connected to and to stay in contact with all of you, our families, and anyone and everyone in our community, and even around the world. People around the world are watching and viewing and following us through our social media outlets. And we want to do everything we can to stay in contact with you, pass along information as soon as we can, the plans that we have moving forward. We want to place materials and resources in your hands to encourage and help you. We are asking our families to learn how to use a computer, a website, some type of social media. And I know that for many of us, that's just not been something at the top of our priority list. But now's the time when it can be a very useful tool, even if it's just for times like this. We are asking you to please keep us updated. Let us know, keep us informed about any needs that you're aware of, prayer requests that you may have. You can contact us here weekdays in the mornings. Just give us a call. There'll be somebody here at the office, and you can talk to a real person. And you can share those things, or you can pass those things on through social media, Facebook, several Instagram accounts that we've given you links to on our Facebook pages, and you can pass those things along to us, and we want to know them. We have placed online now. We put it on there late last night, and it is now available for you on our Facebook page and website. Some resources for families with children. You'll find them there. And they're simple Sunday school lessons that you can do with your toddler, that you can do with your elementary school age child, and you can do them right there in your own home. I want to encourage our parents to use them. I hope you'll set aside a time on Sunday to look at those lessons together, and on a Wednesday night to take time to gather around the Word of God with your children. It's important that we minister to our children during this time. They see more than we think. They hear more than we think. They watch our lives, and we want to encourage them. And it's important to minister to them. They need to have the assurance of God's Word in their heart and in their life. They need to have some normalcy right now. And that time with them on a Sunday in God's Word or a Wednesday night can be a very important and helpful way to do that. It's an important teaching time for you parents right now, this time of challenge we're in. It's a time you can show faith in God to your family. You can help them to see that you believe in His Word and that you're making God and His Word and prayer a priority in your heart and home, even though we might not be able to meet together here on our campus. There are also resources that we placed on there for young adults, teenagers, and college students. They're going through a very disruptive time right now with schools being released and colleges and students being sent home. And, they're still at a very formative time in their life. And we're putting online and our website and Facebook some scriptural outlines and some encouraging instructional biblical truth that'll help them. And so I hope all you parents will be aware of those and just encourage your child, your young person, to use them and spend some time discussing them with them and help them and encourage them and strengthen them during this time. Well, you know, history and God's Word teach us that the church has faced challenging and difficult times before. It's in these times that we actually can grow. It's in these times we can be strengthened, refined. It's in these times that we can experience a personal revival. It's in these times that we can have certain privileges that we have as a child of God that we often grow indifferent to in our busy lives, revitalized. So it is an important time. This is a time when really we can move forward spiritually. It's a time when we can restore back into our hearts and homes those things that cannot be taken away from us as a child of God, regardless of any trial. During these times, I want to encourage you to take advantage in your home of the privilege of prayer. The Bible says in Hebrews 4:16, "Let us therefore come boldly under the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." We have an invitation from God Himself to come to Him. We can pray about anything, anyone, at any time, anywhere that person or that thing may be around the world. In times of trials, it's time to pray. In times of crisis, it's a time to seek Christ. We see in the Scriptures how the church turned to prayer in those times. After the Lord's death, the church prayed. They prayed and sought God, and they waited on the moving of the Holy Spirit. When Peter was imprisoned in the book of Acts, they prayed. They prayed, they looked to God, God heard their prayer, and Peter was set free. And God's people saw God's power in times of trials. They saw God's faithfulness in times when they were being persecuted. And so pray. I encourage you to pray for safety, health-wise and otherwise, of your families. Just pray God will hedge us in and keep us safe. Pray for needs to be met in the lives of others. Those that are our seniors, those that are working and are around, those that might be at risk of carrying this virus, our medical professionals. We have so many of them that are associated with our church or our preschool and daycare. Pray for those in our community where it's just been deemed best for them not to work, and the loss of income or other things that might be a result of that. Pray for needs to be met. Pray for the families in your community. There are so many in our community that don't have a faith view of life. They have no foundation of scriptural truth. They have no hope. Fear and anxiety preys on them, and they view things from that perspective. Pray for them that in this difficult trial, they'll see the light of the Lord in your life and turn to the Lord. Pray for our church families as we're separated. Lift us up one together. Take your church directory and pray down through there for your families of your church. It's a time to grow. Pray and ask the Lord to search you and know you and try you and restore and revive your personal relationship with the Lord. Pray for revival among God's people, our country. Pray for the lost. Pray for our leaders. Pray for our country. Pray for the needs and provisions of your church, that our needs here will be met during this time when we can't get together physically. There's still all the normal needs of this church that have to be met. So pray about these things. Take advantage of the privilege of prayer. While we're in these times, take advantage and have fellowship with your family. Our families are God's gift to us. And during this time, some have extra time in the home. And that time is a unique gift. It's a time when we can treasure our families and be thankful for them and toward them. Read God's Word together as a family. Pray together as a family. Join together as a family and watch these services online. 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings over the next couple weeks. 5 p.m. on Sunday evenings. 7 p.m. on Wednesday nights. Make that time when you're all together as a family. Parents, I want to encourage you to encourage your children right now. Teach them not to be afraid. God hasn't given us a spirit of fear. Teach them to be brave and trust in Jesus Christ, that they don't have to fear. Use the resources we're providing for you. Share with them the great promises of God's Word. So take the privilege of prayer. Fellowship with your family. Bear one another's burdens. And though we may not physically be meeting together, we can still pray for and lift the burdens of others to the Lord. Take time to make a phone call that you've thought about making, but you've never made it. Check on others. Put the needs of others before yourself. If you know of a need, try to help meet that need safely. Notify us of needs that you're aware of, and we'll do what we can to safely help others. Hope in your Heavenly Father right now is a time to do that. We have a Heavenly Father who loves us so much. He gave us His Son, and there's no doubt He loves us and cares for us and our families. The greatest expression anyone has ever shown anyone is Jesus Christ on the cross, God giving to you His Son, and His Son suffering and giving His life for you. This is a challenging time, but we don't have to lose hope. 1 Peter chapter 1, the Bible says in verse 6, "Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ." I want you to be hopeful and be faithful. I know that whether you're at home or anywhere else, you're required to be. Let your hope and faith in Jesus Christ be seen in you. You know, light shines the brightest when it's in the darkest place. So be a light of hope and faith to those around us who are in the dark. Continue to live a Christ-like life. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, and beginning in the 12th verse, the Bible said, "Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them." I want you to notice that the Word of God uses and gives us the word continue. 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 Continue to believe. Continue to live a Christ-like life of faith. The Apostle Paul wrote, led of the Holy Spirit in Philippians 4, verse 12, "I know how both to be abased and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me." I want to encourage you during this time to continue in faith. Live a faith life. Continue to read the Word of God and pray. Those five things that we so often talk about, that if we'll make them a part of our everyday lives, they will enable us to get a grip on living the true Christian life. Reading God's Word and prayer. And even though at the moment we can't assemble ourselves together physically, we can gather ourselves as a family and we can share in these online services and hear from God. Continue to share and be a light and be a witness and reach out to those that are struggling in this time. And then be sure to continue to give and invest in the work of God through your local church. And we've given several online ways and resources for you to do that. And so continue in faith. Continue to further the work of God in the world. Let's be sure we give attention to and care for these things, and let's continue. You know, I'm praying for you I'm praying for your families to come through this time as gold refined in the fire. And I covet your prayers for me and my family. I'm excited this morning now just to open up God's Word for a moment and to be able to look into that source of strength and hope. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing comes by the Word of God. And so take your Bible and get them ready. Open it up to the Old Testament book of Psalms, the 23rd Psalm, and we're going to look at that passage of Scripture again. But first, I want to say how blessed we were by having Dr. Giler and the choir from the Marietta Bible College with us recently. And I know many people were not able to hear them or be in that service. That service is available to watch through our YouTube channel. We hope you'll go there, Tri-State Baptist Media, and watch that service. I know it'll be a blessing to you. But I want to share now one of the songs that they sang for us. And I know that it's going to bless you and be an encouragement to you this morning and your family. And so as soon as we have that song, then we'll look into the Word of God together. Again, to hear that, and we're thankful for the choir, the ministry of Marietta Bible College, and be praying for them. God will meet their needs and to strengthen and protect Dr. and Mrs. Giler. And we'll hear more of those songs over the next few weeks in some of our online services. But that was a blessing, and I know that it was also a blessing to you as well. But take your Bible there as you have it open to Psalm 23, and we want to look at this passage of Scripture together. And we looked at this passage as well on Wednesday evening during our online service, but I want you to see some other, I believe, encouraging and helpful truth that we can find in this book of the Bible. Psalm 23, I want you to think this morning with me for just a little while about the comfort of the shepherd, the comfort of the shepherd. Our Bible says, beginning in Psalm 23 there, and verse number 1, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For Thou art with me, Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And we'll stop right there, but I want you to think about that with me. The comfort of the shepherd. The comfort of the shepherd. Let's just go to the Lord in prayer as we look to Him and His Word this morning. Heavenly Father, thank You for being good and gracious to us. And we just ask today, Lord, that You would just empower Your Word. We thank You, God, that, Lord, You fill the heavens and the earth. And God, we thank You for Your Holy Spirit. Every born-again believer who knows You as their Savior, Lord, You are in them, and the Spirit of God is in them and with them right at this moment. So, God, search us, know our needs, meet those needs today. Lord, encourage Your people, strengthen them, give them faith, a measure, God, equal to the day we live in. And Lord, we pray that through these difficult times, that God, You'll do great and mighty things. I pray that someday we'll look back about this time, and Lord, we'll talk about, yeah, I remember that. I remember these folks who came to know the Lord. I remember this family who were brought back to You. I remember the great and mighty things that God did. And so, Lord, we're looking to You to do that. So strengthen us by Your Word. Increase our faith. Help us to make the most of every one of the unique opportunities that are around us through this time. And help us just to be faithful. Help us, God, to look to You and Your Word. Lord, there could be someone watching this online service now or at a later date that doesn't know You as their personal Savior. They don't know the comfort of the shepherd. They don't have a personal relationship with You. They cannot say, the Lord is my shepherd. And Lord, they're struggling. They have anxiety and fear and uncertainty. Lord, they're dealing with emotions and, Lord, sometimes even anger. And I'm praying today that, God, You'll minister to them, that they'll come to see and know You, and that, God, Your Word will do a great work in their heart and life. And, Lord, they'll look back at this time as a time, God, that became one of the most important and precious times of their life. And so today we're looking to You to do these things, and we're thanking You for what You will do. And we ask it all today in Jesus' name we pray, and amen. Well, we are thankful for you who are joining us this morning, and I hope that you'll just spend a few moments and stay with us here as we look at the Word of God. You know, we're living in a time right now when, if we allowed ourselves, we could be very uncomfortable. When we endure hardship, when we find ourselves under stress, when things aren't like they normally are, that's usually the time that we seek comfort in that which is familiar to us. We seek comfort of those whom we know love us and care for us. In Psalm 23, the Lord Jesus wants to remind people of His love and care for them. He wants us to be reminded that we can draw near to Him and that we'll find comfort and peace in the presence of our shepherd. In Psalm 23, I want you to notice some very simple things here today. And I hope you'll write them down and you'll have them that you can look at and discuss them later. But write down simply, number one, the personal shepherd. The personal shepherd. Verse 4 says, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me." Thou art with me. I want you to notice the position of the sheep. They're walking through the valley of the shadow of death. The shadow of death is upon them. And we certainly can apply that, you know, as we look at our country, the situation really that's encompassed much of the world today. We know that there are many people who feel as if the shadow of death is upon them. But in reality, whether it's in a time of crisis like we're in with our health and disease, or whether things seem to be normal, we know that our lives are very fragile. We're but a hand's breadth away from eternity, one breath away at any moment. And we're walking through life that way. And many people do not know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. They are one breath away from the door of death opening up and them stepping out into eternity unprepared. But I want you to notice here the position here of the sheep. They're walking through the valley of the shadow of death. But notice the presence of the shepherd is there. Thou art with me. Thou art with me. I want you to consider today that there is a real personal relationship that you can have with Jesus Christ. You know, it's possible not just to talk about Jesus Christ, but to know Him and talk to Him. And this is possible because He's the Good Shepherd who gave His life for the sheep. He's the Good Shepherd who has risen from the dead and is present in this world today. You can know Him as your shepherd by placing your faith and trust in His completed work. A good shepherd not only will give His life for the sheep, but He knows their very needs. He's committed to His sheep. He's faithful to meet the needs of His sheep. Back in verse number 1, the Bible said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake." The Lord Jesus is great at being our shepherd. He's the great shepherd who cares for His sheep. He knows our every need. He knows them before we know them. And He has provision for them. And He wants us to have a personal relationship with Him. He desires it. This is what He wants, a close relationship. He wants to lead us. He wants us to be close enough to keep our eyes on Him and let Him guide us. And He wants us to know that He is with us through the trials and shadows of life. "Thou art with me." That's a word of assurance by the sheep, even though they're going through the valley of the shadow of death. Let me ask you this morning, do you know that? Do you know the Lord is with you? Do you know today that He is with you? Can you say that? This is the desire of Jesus Christ for you, for everyone, above all other things today, to know that He is real. He's not a statue that someone has carved out or created that sets in some prominent place or adorns or decorates some place where people gather for religious things. He's more than a painting, some man's rendering of what he thinks Jesus, God, might be like. He's more than just a figure hanging on a wall. He's not a piece of artwork or a piece of jewelry. He is real. He's a real person this morning. He wants to have, and He will have with you, a real personal relationship so that you can say, "The Lord is with me." This is what He wants today. He wants to be personal. He wants a relationship with you to be personal. But write down a second thing, if you would. There is a powerful shepherd with you. He wants to be a personal shepherd. He wants to have a relationship with you. But He's also a powerful shepherd. Notice verse 4 says, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me." You know, the shepherd's tools are very simple things. He has a rod and he has a staff. The rod was his weapon. He used it against the wild animals that might prey on the sheep, on the flock. He used it on the enemies of the sheep. It was simply a strong stick. But the young shepherd was taught and he learned how to use that rod. He could throw it. He was accurate. He could use it and wield it and swing it so that he might strike the enemies and drive them away. I remember when we were in Africa on a mission trip in 2010 that we were at church, and that church was kind of off the road and out into some fields filled with sunflowers and other different kinds of crops. And we began to notice after we were there a little while that that occasionally we would catch glimpse of some shepherds. And they were Maasai. They were young men who were watching the flocks of goats and sheep for their tribe. And these shepherds still had those same tools all these many years later, their staff or their rod. And they were watching over their sheep. The staff the shepherd used was usually a tall stick, like a walking stick. Usually with one end of that staff, it would be curved or it would be hooked. The shepherd could use that long staff to lean on, but most often it was used to guide the sheep. And sometimes to retrieve a sheep that had gotten away from the flock and had gotten themselves into trouble. The shepherd could reach out with that staff and he could hook that sheep and pull them back to safety. Maybe a lamb would get caught in the briars or the thickets and or possibly might fall into the stream and couldn't swim and reach the other side. That shepherd could take that staff and he could place it around the body of that animal and he could pull that lamb back into safety. The shepherd had his rod to guard the sheep, and the shepherd had his staff to guide them. And the sheep learned that the shepherd had everything that he needed for every need of his lives. That brought peace and comfort to the sheep. When a sheep was distraught, or maybe when a sheep was afraid, the shepherd could just touch them with his staff, and he could draw them closer to him, and they could walk near to him, and they would not be afraid. And this is what we need to do right now. We need to draw close to the Lord. We need to know that our shepherd has all power given unto him in heaven and earth. Our shepherd can walk on the water. Our shepherd can heal any manner of sickness and disease. Our shepherd can raise the dead. He is your shepherd if you know him as your personal Savior. He can be your powerful shepherd if you trust him with your soul. Trust in, believe in the finished work of Jesus Christ for you. Jesus Christ today is a shepherd. He wants to be your shepherd. He wants to be a personal shepherd. He wants you to know Him and enter into a personal relationship with Him through faith in His finished work. He came into the world and He went to the cross. And there on the cross, the shepherd became the Lamb of God. And He gave His life. He offered it up as a payment for your sin debt. He paid your sin debt. And He died the death you deserve to die. He did it so He could rise again from the grave. He did it so He has power over death and the grave. He did it so that He might offer to you eternal life and forgiveness of sins, and He might enter into your heart and life as your shepherd. He wants to have a personal relationship with you. He is a powerful shepherd. He has everything we need to care for us and meet our needs. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. He's guarding me. He's guiding me. He provides for me all the things that I need. The Lord Jesus is my shepherd. I know that even though I'm going through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for He is with me. He wants you to know Him today. But just write down one third and final thing. There is a present shepherd for you. There is a present shepherd for you. Jesus Christ is powerful. He is a shepherd who wants to be your personal shepherd. And He is a present shepherd to those who are His sheep. If you know Jesus Christ this morning personally, then you have a powerful shepherd who is present with you always. You'll never have to truly say, I need to try to find the Lord. I don't know where He is. You'll never truly have to say that. Sometimes we allow the circumstances and situations of our life to take us away from the nearness of the Lord. We walk and wander away as sheep. We're prone to wander. Sometimes that happens and we might feel like we don't know where the Lord is, but we really don't need to ask that. In fact, we never really need to say, I don't know where the Lord is, because Jesus Christ is an ever-present shepherd for His sheep. He never leaves His sheep. Hebrews 13:5 says, let your conversation be without covetousness and be content with such things as you have. For He has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Jesus Christ is the ever-present shepherd. He's all-powerful and He is personal. He is a personal shepherd for your life. In Psalm 27, the Bible says in verse 1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. I want to leave you this morning with that assurance of knowing that if you have and know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you have a present shepherd with you. He's watching over you. He knows and sees the needs of your life. He's leading and guiding you. He'll lead you into green pastures. He'll lead you to the still water. As we go through the valleys of the shadows of death, He's with us. We're not alone. His rod and staff are there to guard us and guide us. He has all power. He'll never leave us. He'll never forsake us against our enemies and our adversaries. I want you to strengthen your heart and home through these truths. I want you to be assured this morning that Jesus Christ is your personal Savior. If you don't know today Jesus Christ is your Savior, I want you to know it's a simple matter of asking and believing. The Bible said, "Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." When I was saved and trusted Jesus Christ as my Savior, I didn't have all the answers. I didn't know everything there was to know about God and the Bible. But I knew I needed a Savior. I knew I was a sinner, lost. I was without strength. I had no hope. I had no peace. And I knew there wasn't anything I could do to change it. I knew that the world, the flesh, the devil were foes that I could not defeat. But I heard about what God did for me. And in love, He sent His Son for me. His Son died on the cross, paid my sin debt. He was buried but rose again. He lived. He was a living Savior. And He invited me to ask His forgiveness and receive the gift of eternal life. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that's what I did. I didn't feel funny all over when I did that. I didn't see lights flashing or hear bells going off. I simply believed and trusted in the gospel, the Word of God for my life. If you're watching this video, if you're somewhere looking for some help, some strength, if you would like to have and know Jesus Christ as your personal shepherd, it's a very simple thing. Ask God to forgive you of your sin. It's our sin, mine and yours, that was the reason Jesus Christ had to suffer and die on the cross. Ask God the Father to forgive you for sending His Son to the cross. And then ask the Son to forgive your sin and come into your heart and life. Tell Him that you believe what He did for you and that you want to rest your eternal soul in His hands. He's a living Savior. He's your shepherd. And the Bible said if you will call upon Him, He will answer you and He will give you eternal life. We're thankful today for that hope and promise. I hope that you know that He is with you. If you don't, or if you have questions, or if you want help concerning these things, please contact us. Give us a call here at the church or contact us via any of our social media platforms. And we'll take all the time we need to give you what you need so that you can know personally that Jesus Christ is your Savior. I want you to know today and be encouraged through the Word of God and realize that there is comfort in the Shepherd. Even in these difficult times, He wants us to know He's with us. So as we get ready to conclude our morning service, I hope that these things will be an encouragement to you. And I hope you'll stay in contact with us and let us know if you have a need that we can meet. And we want to be a help to you. But look to Jesus Christ. Have hope in Him. Take the time right now during this unique time to continue to do those things that we can do as the people of God. And so we look to you. And don't forget, we'll be back online tonight at 5 p.m. And so we hope that you'll join together with your family and to watch the service that we'll have at 5 p.m. So we look forward to being with you again at that time. God bless you. And we'll be back online with our Wednesday evening service at 7 p.m. On this coming Wednesday. God bless you. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank You for being good and gracious to us. We thank You for the Word of God. It is our strength. It is our comfort. It is our hope. It is our foundation. Is it eternal? It is unchanging. Lord, we thank You for Jesus Christ. We thank You that He is our shepherd. We can know Him. We can say, "The Lord is my shepherd." We can say that even though they're walking through the valley of the shadow of death, Thou art with me. And so, Lord, we pray today that Your people will take comfort in the presence and personal relationship of their powerful shepherd. And we're praying today that if someone watching this service doesn't know you as their shepherd, that God, they will look to you, trust you, and believe in you. Or Lord, they will contact us and let us help them as they come into a real relationship with you. So we commit all these things into your hands. We're trusting in you. We believe you're greater God than any problem that we'll face. You're greater God than any challenge that we might go through. And so, God, we're trusting in you. Help us to grow, be a light, and shine in the darkness, and lead others to Jesus Christ. We pray and ask it all in Jesus' name, and amen. Oh, good morning. We hope you'll have just a great day, and we'll see you this evening online at 5 p.m.